first we had JEE Advanced exam, and I hope it went well for you people. So talking about chemistry section, it was an amalgam of average, easy and few relatively difficult questions. We can say that it was a mixture of conceptual and calculation based questions. Plus, one new thing was introduced in it. There were matching type questions which were different as compared to the previous years. Coming to the weightage which was given to the syllabus of class 11th versus class 12th, it's almost equal. Now let's do a thorough analysis of both of the papers. In paper 1, there were 18 questions asked in 3 different sections. In section 1, 7 questions were there, and those questions were having multiple correct options. So plus 4 marks were given for a completely correct answer. Then there was negative marking, so minus 2 were deducted for marking any incorrect option. Moreover, there was partial marking, which means plus 1 mark was given for darkening a bubble corresponding to each correct option. So we can say this section was not very difficult. Even the questions from thermodynamics and solutions, they were average. Though there was one slightly tricky question from stereochemistry, but other than that, average questions from p-block elements and coordination compounds were asked in it. Coming to section 2, there were 5 questions in this section, and these questions were answered in a single digit. So each correct answer could fetch plus 3 marks. So this section was simple. Very easy questions were asked in it. There were 2 questions from electrochemistry and solid state. They were really simple. Then 2 more questions from hybridization and molecular orbital theory were there, again simple. Then there was 1 question in which you had to find the number of aromatic compounds, easy peasy. Lastly, coming to section 3, in this section, 6 questions were asked and they were of matching type. So this section was relatively tougher. So as I have already told you in my previous video, that quantum mechanical model of an atom was very important. So yes, there were 3 questions asked from it. And other than that, there were 3 questions from organic chemistry. So that's all about paper 1. Now coming to paper 2, which was slightly difficult than paper 1. So again in this paper, 18 questions were asked. In section 1, we were having 7 questions. And these 7 questions were having plus 3 marks for correct answer. In this section, more weightage was given to physical chemistry, which automatically increased the difficulty level of the section. Plus, more time was consumed for solving questions given in this section. Coming to section 2, again, 7 questions were asked in it, and these questions were having multiple correct options. So, this section was relatively simple. There were some very simple questions asked from chemical kinetics, chemical equilibrium, and surface chemistry. Then there were 2 questions from organic chemistry. Other than that, there were 2 factual questions from inorganic chemistry. So lastly, coming to section 3, there were 4 questions in this section. Basically, 2 paragraphs were given, and from each paragraph, you had to answer 2 questions. So this section was more inclined towards high difficulty level. So that's all about chemistry's exam. We can say that paper was moderate compared to last year, slightly tricky, and as expected, more conceptual. So now soon results will also be announced. So let's hope for the best.